Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and today we are going to continue our playthrough of Dark Souls 3. When we last left off, we had just dealt with Yol, and as you can see, I hollowed to 16, and I added a couple points to Vigor and a couple points to Luck. That'll help us a little bit. Every little bit helps. So we're going to continue at the Halfway Fortress here, and there's a couple ways that you can go about doing this. It's one of the first areas in the game where you really have a choice between which way you want to go. So I always like choices. So we got a new type of enemy. They have giant trees. I could have attacked them. I was close. I almost ran out of life there. Okay, so the first thing I guess we can do. I kind of want to land on the dog, but I'll take my chances with this guy. Oh. Why, hello there. Wow. I was behind him. Take care of him. I don't know what they're looking at. Probably an alluring skull. Titanite shard. Alright. There's actually a lot of treasure in this area, so we do have to proceed with a teeny tiny little bit of caution. There's a lot of things we can pick up. If your weapons are not upgraded to +3, they soon will be. Okay, let's heal. There's a couple guys here hiding in the bushes. They can be difficult to spot, so just pay attention. There's another one over here. I was behind him. Twice I was behind. What? Guy ain't even looking at me. The twin dragon shield. Oh, hello. Oh dear, I hit dogs. As you guys know. Look at all these guys. This path, it's best to just walk through the forest. And if memory serves me correctly, there's a bonfire right here. Yes, thank God. Let's see. Light the bonfire. You don't need to sit at it. I don't think that would help us very much right now, so. Ooh, almost. It looks like I'm behind him, doesn't it? But for whatever reason, just not working. Works for me. Ooh. An Estus shard. Alright. Now we're cooking. Got one, this is a new type enemy. I don't really know what to call it. A horror? They cannot be backstabbed, so don't even bother trying. Just R1 the crap out of him. Another soul. Now this swamp has a ton of items in it. But for now, we're going to run all the way over to the other side of this wonderful building. Crystal lizard. Drops a crystal gem. Well, not exactly all that useful, but we do have to be careful here. There is a sorcerer. Oh, I thought he was dead when he bled. And he's gone. Actually, that was a lot easier than it normally is for them. Ring of Sacrifice. Not really worth all that much to me. A couple souls. Okay. So we might as well head over this way for a second. Thank you for just standing there. Actually, this isn't the way I want to go. Yet. We want to go up and out. I thought this was actually the same one in the same path, that's why. But it's not. Okay. Golden Falcon Shield. Okay. So now we're going to have to fight this guy. You can see him right there. He's not the only one. There's actually two of them. They're like a package deal, usually. Totally backstabbable. Wrong button. But he wears fairly heavy armor, which has fairly high bleed resistance. Oh, you are not. No. You don't get to heal. Ever. And he drops the Great Club. You can see the guy in there. He's just chilling. Oh, right in the head. And this guy's got a giant curved sword. Again. Ooh, I don't know what I was doing there. Oh, this guy's got some poise. And hacks, because his attacks home in on you. Pain in my ass, aren't you? Gotcha. And again. And that does it for this guy. Wait, you don't want me to slash ya? Drops the Exile Greatsword, which is actually a pretty cool weapon. Homeward Bone. This is Farron Keep. There's nothing down here, but you can see on the other side of this passage, there's an item there. That item is actually relatively important if you wish to progress in the game. As far as... well, I don't want to spoil it. We're almost there. I'm going to light the bonfire, which is down the ladder here. Alright, so you have a choice here. You can either go to this area and continue on in Farron Keep, or you can continue on up the ladder and go to the next possible area and fight the boss as well as go on past there. It's really your choice. Both areas are comparable in terms of difficulty, I would say. The boss, however, to this next area, if we go back up here, is much, much easier than the one we're going to fight down in Farron Keep. The enemies are also a teeny tiny bit easier. A lot of people do not like Farron Keep, and rightfully so. It's a bit of a frustrating area. Which way do I want to go here? Because I need to get those two items there from, like, completion here. And we want, Mr. Crab, because they can just attack through the walls and shit. I can't do that. Get the Swamp Tome and the Conjurer's Set. And there's some green blossom here we don't need, but we'll get it anyway. And one last item, which is the Grass Crest Shield. You can kill these crabs if you really want to. I actually think one of them drops a ring if you manage to kill it. Whoa, he's on land. That never happens. Do not cheat me. You get back in the water. So if you're like me and you prefer to do things the other way, was that an item I missed? No. Then the only way to go about doing this is to head back across. Is that the only way? No, that's not the only way of doing it. What am I talking about? What kind of crack am I smoking? No, I think I lied. Well, now I'm confused. Can I get back up here? Yeah, okay, never mind. I was smoking some crack. Yes, you have to have the sound effects or the game doesn't work. It's not nearly as effective. You can just stand there, I don't really care. No, okay, nothing over there. Have to be careful when you're navigating that you don't accidentally fall down. It's happened to me more times than I care to admit. And this is going to bring us to...
Well, this is unexpected. I don't often have visitors. What do you want? This is my study that you've happened upon. If you haven't any business, I've reading to get back to. How intriguing. Very well. Indeed, I am a sorcerer, with plenty to share. However, what champion demands service without recompense? Clearly, you're not that sort of man. So you will make me a promise, that in exchange for my teaching, you will bring me knowledge. In the form of scrolls detailing sorcery's secrets. Well, can you assure me of this? Very well. You're no fool. I take it you understand the weight of a promise. I am Orbeck of Vinheim, Unkindled One. I shall teach you sorceries. We will learn together. It shall be like our very own school.
Now, just so you guys know, if you don't have 10 intellect, or intelligence, I should say, you cannot, he won't leave. So you need at least 10 for him to leave the area. Okay, so I don't think there's actually anything in this room. So let's just jump down. Avoid this guy. Oh, I had you. I had you. Okay, let's not do this. Yeah, let's get out of here because this is pointless. Goodbye. Goodbye. And we have a boss battle with Crystal Sage. Whoa, that hurt. Really not a particularly difficult boss battle. However, he just randomly appears. Some of his attacks can be kind of nasty, so it's a good idea to try your best to avoid him. Let's Ember. Give myself a little extra life. Not that I think I'll need it for him. When he goes to half-life, he changes his tactics. He'll summon clones. The clones are fairly easy to detect. They shoot blue. He shoots purple. I see him. Oh, I hate the Soul Home Missile Beacon of Death. Where are you? I usually go after the first one that I see, just to kill it. Ooh. Oh, I see him. Wow, he's all the way in that fucking corner. There he is, he's dead. I was a little hairy there towards the end. Okay, so we defeated the Crystal Sage. Alright. So now it's your choice which way you want to go. Do you want to go up this path here, which a lot of people, their first playthrough, don't even realize it's there because it's fairly well hidden? Or do you want to go the other way? Really, it doesn't matter which way you decide to go. I wonder if you can parry this guy. Was a little bit of a doozy. You can actually fall down here, but I wanted to kill him first. And I believe there's a crystal lizard. There it is. Twinkling titanite. Oh dear. Deary, deary me. I kind of want to kill her, but at the same point in time, I see there's another one of these cage dudes. So why don't we see if we can't kill him first? Never mind. I just walked around a big circle. Whoa. Okay. Well, I guess we're going to fight him. Okay, stop it with that camera. Try not to roll off the cliff here. God, you make enough noise, you'll aggro the whole planet. You don't see me. That's why I'm an assassin. Oh, what the hell was that? Rolled, alright. Don't roll. Here, you can mess with me, woman. The Herald set. Alright. Alright, so here's the next area we're about to come up to here. I guess it doesn't actually tell us what the name of it is yet. Hey, buddy. Oh! I thought you were just gonna let me stab you. Oh, God, that was awful. Hold on. Oh, don't you be doing that. Don't you be... Oh, I have no stamina. I was wondering why I couldn't do anything. Here, come. Cheating piece of shit. Cheating piece of shit. I hate cheaters. Alright, now I'm pissed off. Hey, you wanna mess with me? I'll show you who's better. Hey, you wanna roll? Better than you. Ha ha. Okay. We get the Paladin's Ashes. I wonder how long we've been playing for. He doesn't respawn as far as I know. Let's see, we're about 35. So, only 15 minutes. That can't be right. That definitely can't be right. I feel like there's something over there. But I feel like if I fall in there, I may never come back out. Oh yeah, okay, alright. I think there is something over there. Oh. Well, hello. What's the point of this? The Crest Shield. Wow. If there was a guy who attacked with Dark, that would be the shield for it. This I picked up before too. The Grass Shield. The Grass Shield. Right. It's got high stability. This was the Falcon Eagle Shield, which kind of... Look at him. Ooh, I'm going to just... Oh, yeah. I gotta... Oh, God almighty. No. Oh, God. Oh, he's kicking me. What's up with you guys in darts? Gotcha. That looked like a... bootleg parry though. Taste my blade. Ooh. Haha. Should have parried your knife. Alright, I'm tired of messing around with you. I like how you just home in on me with your cheat. The Spider Shield. I kind of like that shield. Wow, 3.5. Never mind, I don't like it at all. I can use that. Doesn't look like a particularly good shield. Oh, this area. Oh, this area is fun. Dogs and archers and everything in between. Okay, not very smart dogs though, mind you. I can hear it. Look at them all. Look at that cheater. Haha. Whoa. Crap. Heal. I think there's an item over... Oh yeah, there is. Alright, you can stay there. Oh! Damn it! Oh, hold that for that. How many more dogs are there? Jesus. Alright, here we go. Here's our next bonfire. No. This guy sets himself on fire. So we can do that. Alright, well, I think here is as good a place as any to stop. This is the Cleansing Chapel. We're heading on to the main goal in this area. Wonder if it tells you. Yeah, the Cathedral of the Deep. Okay, it does, but it didn't pop up on the thing. That's weird. So we can upgrade our Estus flask to another charge. So I think we're going to do that. We're going to level, and then we will take a quick spin around here because there's a couple things that we can do.
That is good. What?
Kind of, there weren't more than one. No.
Okay, be careful.
Where is our boy Grierat? We should be able to do something with him now.
Ah, there you are. I was thinking. You know I'm a petty thief. Well, perhaps I'll go on the prowl. Everyone's dead or hollowed away anyway, right? So I might as well fetch some weapons or treasure for you. Well, what do you say? Thank you.
And okay, so you can send him to pillage. And then the next time you come back to town, he should be gone. Now, the other thing is, now Yol has died. He is dead. Poor guy. And he is replaced with this woman.
Oh, prithee. Art thou good Yol's master? I am Uria of Londor, a close friend of his. Thanks to thee, Yol's soul is redeemed. Allow me to express my gratitude in his stead.
Get a gesture.
Thou art a lord, art thou not? Bearer of the dark sigil, and our lord of hollows. For the time thou remainst our lord, we of Londor shall serve thee. And I, of course, am also thine. Till we meet again.
Now you can actually kill her. And a lot of people do, just to prevent the quest from moving forward. If you kill her, you get her weapon, which is the Dark Blade or whatever it's called. It's a katana. It's actually really, 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 really good.
Oh, champ, I was not meant to be a firekeeper. The god, I am you.
Yeah, great.
Oh, you've brought me a Braille divine tome. Now I can tell new tales of miracles. Tales of the greater miracles can be quite the epics. What fun we will have.
Now, there are things called, like, dark miracles or dark tomes, whatever you want to call them. If you give them to her, it's not a good idea. She can actually turn mad because of them. There's another character that you can give them to prevent that from happening. I think, is he up there? No, I don't see him. He's just chilling. Nope. Okay. So let's level.
Welcome, host. Very well. Then Hagen.
Okay, I got 4 levels, so why don't we put one into endurance, one into luck, 2 into dex. Start pumping some points into dexterity. Alright. Well, I think I'm going to stop this video here, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Take care and have a great day.